What's up? It's me, Priscilla. Now, it's been a while since I've done one of these. This is a fun video called What's in My Pencil Bag. Now, this is my go-to pencil bag. It goes with me everywhere. As you can see, it's really big, full of noises, and it's actually a makeup case from 31 bags that my friend sold to me. So I actually broke the zipper off, so I have to trace it around the side to open it up, and then this is what's inside. You can see my first appeal when I saw this bag. It's just a makeup bag. See, this is where like my makeup brushes would go, but instead I have a couple of paintbrushes, some nice paintbrushes that I have, just in case I want to bring watercolor. And the fun thing about this pencil case, if I have a watercolor project, here's my Koi watercolor set, and it fits perfectly inside. If you go back here, you can see I have a couple of Bristol board pieces of paper, just a little couple things in case I want to do a small project. Little dingle hopper for my iPhone, and I've got a couple of bobby pins, emergency bobby pins, just in case. Got a nice little protractor. This is how I make my circles on my drawings if I just want an easy background. Then you can see in here, I've got a ton of Colorase pencils. So these are Prismacolor Colorase pencils, and you can see they're all different colors, and this is what I use to sketch with. So I've got all these beautiful colors, and you can see they're all different shapes and sizes. And I'm writing, such as in my planner, or if I'm just jotting notes down. These are Paper Mate Ink Joy gel pens. These are my favorite writing utensils. They're so nice, they go on so smooth, and they dry super fast. They're not like super blotchy pens where if you drag your hand across it, I know that happens a lot for left-handers, so if you drag your hand across it, then it won't smudge. So that's what I really, really, really like about these. Three ballpoint pens, and I've got two really pretty Bic round stick grip ballpoint pens. These are purple, and then here is a black one. So in case I want to do any cross-hatching with my purple pens or my black pen, these are my favorite. This is such a pretty purple color. I saw my friend Tori in church writing in her journal, her Bible journal, taking down her notes with this purple pen, and I asked her for some, and we went and bought some that day, so these are beautiful. I have a single Copic marker sketch in here. It's N2. It's just a little bit of fun grayscale highlighting I can go in with my sketches just to give it a little bit of color and a little bit of depth by adding a little bit of shading to it. I have one mechanical pencil just in case I want to do any pencil sketches, and it's a Staedtler Tri Plus Micro 0.5 lead, and then I've got a really light 2H pencil. I have a single black Prismacolor pencil. I like to use this as opposed to going in and lining with a liner. I like to sometimes go in with my sketches and line with a black colored pencil. Cron multi-liners are my favorite to use, so I'm really particular about this brand. Got like a 01, I've got a brush tip pin, I've got a 1, and then I have a 03, and these are all black. So I'm a huge, huge fan of these. These are all the sizes that I have. I have two white jelly roll white gel pens. I will not use another brand. This is the only brand that I like to use. I'm obsessed with Jelly Roll, and I've actually got one Jelly Roll metallic pretty sparkly pen. So these are the three pens that are just kind of hanging out. This is a nice Copic, I don't know how to spell this, Copic Gassim Food. It's a really nice brush tip pen. So I'm really obsessed with this one. This is the same one that Jake Parker uses to line a lot of his artwork. So I love having that with me. And then I have a Copic Multiliner 05 sepia toned liner. I really like this just in case I need to do some skin lining or lining on tanned colored creatures or characters, then I always go to my Copic marker sepia tone. And then I just have one Spectrum Noir Art Liner 03. Two different water brush pens. So I filled these by myself. I filled these my own. So one is a dark, they're both ink and they're washes. So they're basically just diluted watered down ink. So this one is darker than this one. This is more diluted and not as much. So these are really nice to have with me all the time if I want to do like Inktober sketches, or if I just want to fill in my sketches with some nice pretty watercolor, then this would be my go-to things. And the nice thing is if I can get to a sink, I can wash this out and fill it with water and just clean it out, and it'll be completely fine. Clean it out, fill it with just plain water, and then use it if I were to do a watercolor on the go sketch. I could go ahead and use it that way. And of course, I have one kneaded eraser. It lives in the top of my little pencil case, so it doesn't pick anything up. So if I would just go ahead, stick it right up in there, and then it'd be good to go. There is what is inside my pencil case. Edition 2018. I've had this case for maybe almost a whole year. Pack everything inside and just go ahead and take off and go. And all of my supplies can be found in Hobby Lobby, Michaels, or Amazon. They're very I find it's more inexpensive to find things on Amazon as opposed to going out to Michaels and Hobby Lobby. I would choose Michaels over Hobby Lobby because Michaels has some good coupons. These are my favorite art supplies, and I will see you all later.